made up till this moment in this mega project. Yesterday we have seen the people who were buying or who bought the bonds were receiving the revenues from the different banks, and this is the first reap of the profits of the bonds of the Suez Canal mega project. To shed more light on the progress in the work in this project, we are delighted to have our dear guest, Dr. Haysam Mamdouh, the head of Hydraulics and Irrigation Engineering Department, Alexandria University. Hello, Dr. Haysam, and thank you very much for being with us.
Very good morning to you, Doctor.
Thank you.
Yesterday, as Mahisti said, the holders of the certificates and bonds started receiving their first revenues. Tell us a bit about the progress and what this means.
About the, yes, after the declaration of the project by 1 month, President Sisi has declared that this issue to collect 60 billion Egyptian pound, in which 64 billion has been already collected. And after 3 months, because this bonds is with net annual revenue of 12%, in which every 3 months, so the revenue should be issued to the holders. So yesterday, the day before yesterday, 1.9 billion Egyptian pound has been already issued to the stockholders of that project. It has been distributed through more than 7,000 cash corner and bank around Egypt, and without any problem noticed in that issue. So this could be considered for two issues. This is an economical election again for the president. In addition to that, the confidence of that project for normal Egyptian or normal holders of that bond.
To what extent what we have seen yesterday of the people starting to having to have the revenues from the bonds that they have bought could be boosting, could be a boost to the Egyptian economy. Of course, we all know that it's a procedural matter, but the fact that we are receiving the revenues and everything is going smooth and as promised is giving a positive indication.
Simply we could say there is a well-known index, which is known Global Competitiveness Report, which issue every year. Last year, Egypt has been has got the position 118 out of 144 international economy around the world. Let us wait until next July to see what is our new position. This report is based, this position from that report is based about on more than 148 index, in which a lot of them are about index of inflation, about how to could attract the investor from outside the country. So in that report, Switzerland is number one, Singapore is number two, and Egypt is currently is in the position 118. Let us see what is our progress in that report after 7 months from now. I believe that we could easily, according to that, what has been declared and what I could evaluate on the earth, we could easily reach to be about in the 90 place or 85. I hope that.
You are that optimistic.
I'm optimistic. And from a pessimistic point of view, it could be 100.
Okay.
Let us see for within 7 months, because if any scientist or any, you could just follow the Economic International Forum, the Global Competitive Report.
Indeed. Okay.
This is very interesting because this has other implications for Egypt. It means other things, especially for foreign investors, for example, who are keen to come in and join in the investments in such mega projects. How important is our ranking, for example, in such internationally recognized levels, in your opinion?
It's very important because any investor want to invest in Egypt, the first thing that he will see it, the global competitive report. So in that report, we are in some index, we are in the top 10, or from the, for example, in health situation, we are in the highest 30 country. So let us, those index in some, in education, we are in the position 140. So we should just, the government should try to improve the position of Egypt in each index of those 148. So the investor just will see how he could invest his money in Egypt, mainly according to what is named in GCR, or Global Competitive Report.
See away from the economic point, from the progress in the economic field related to the project, what about on the ground? What about the dredging operations taking place? To what extent we are moving ahead in the project of the Suez Canal link?
In the project, there is mainly the main activity is excavation. Mm. There is dry excavation and also the dredging. So in the dry excavation, we had reached about 70% or 75%, in which up till this moment, after 4 months of the launching of that project, we have dredged, we have excavated about 150 million meter cube of sand. So this represents 70% from the dry work. What is very challenging for Egypt or for Suez Canal Authority and also for the Egyptian Army Authority, Engineered Army Authority, that we have about 250 million meter cube, of sand underwater. 250 million meter cube of sand.
Huge amount.
A huge amount, yes. Mm. So this need a dredger. So according to that, there is three consortium who have been involved. One of them is what is called Challenge, consuming several companies. The total number of dredger which will be working in that project is will be about 36 dredger. Mm-hmm. Yesterday, two of them have just arrived. During December, it is expected that around 11 dredger will come also to the project. We hope that we could finalize this project by next August 2015.
It will be the 1 year, as they promised.
Let us talk clearly. Yes, it will be 1 year. But this is quite a big challenge.
It is.
Yes. Mm. To finalize it, it's in August, it is not a simple task.
No, it is not.
Initially planned for 3 years, and now it is just 1 year. So it's quite a big challenge. And we should all, as Egyptians, support the Suez Canal Authority and also the Egyptian Army in that issue.
Indeed.
Right. Recently, the head of the Suez Canal, Mohamed Mamish, announced that upon the Mohamed Mamish announced that upon the directives of President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, there must be creation for job opportunities for youth. And he also announced that the fish cultivation project is almost completed. I remember last time you had some concerns regarding the fisheries.
Yes.
About environmental impact, but the Egyptian Environmental Agency affirmed the minister has signed already a memorandum of understanding, MOU, between the environmental EEA, what the Egyptian Environmental Agency affirmed, and the Suez Canal Authority to study the environmental negative impact of that project. I believe that it is a big concern from economical issue and also from environmental issue, because when you want to make fish farm, you get water by pumping from the Suez Canal up to 5 kilometer length, and this water will be polluted and returned back to the Suez Canal. So we should treat this water before we turn it first. In addition to that, the cost of pumping will not be economic from economical issue, but this could be studied with the assistance of, we have a big authority in Egypt, Fishery Authority. So I have some concern, but on the table, every concern could be solved. Even so, there is some environmental issues which has been declared, and all will be studied by the Egyptian Environmental Agency affair.
But what are the odds about the fisheries? And what about the chances of work, the job opportunities that it could provide? And to what extent it could help the providing of fish to the country and solve many problem of nutrition and other stuff. So to what extent this fishery cultivation could be important for the country?
In Egypt, we produce about 1.5 million ton of fish every year. 90% of this amount are freshwater fish.
From the seas?
No, freshwater from the Nile and also from the northern lagoon or lakes like Manzala Brolos. And about 10% are from the sea fish. So we export a large amount of sea fish. So to make fish cultivation, it is a high technology because we need what is called hatchery to produce small fishes. And we don't have any salt hatchery in Egypt except one in Alexandria, very small in the western part of Alexandria. So this is a high technological. What is called new technology to make fish cultivation is using net in the coastal sea, in like Mediterranean, because this is a running water. But for make fish cultivation inside a lagoon and lake, it will not be running water. So the probability of pollution will be higher.
High.
in addition to the pumping cost. So what is has been declared by Admiral Mohammed Mish, the Suez Canal Authority, this project, in addition to that, what is called declared also by Kamel Wazir from the Egyptian army, that we will build the new Smaaliyah city in the eastern part of Suez Canal, which it is planned to host about 300,000 Egyptians. And it will be a new city with an industrial zone and technological area in that area. So President Sisi has mentioned clearly that he wants to offer job opportunity. Up to now, we have 22,000 job opportunity working in the Suez Canal.
Already.
Already.
And these are new jobs.
New job, new direct job. You could just, when we count it from economic, there is direct job and indirect job. Because those people, when they earn money, they return back to their cities and they, so there is what is called direct job is 22,000, but the unemployability rate, which is one of the GCR index, I think that there is some declaration that it will be have been already reduced a little bit, the unemployment rate, and also the inflation, it is almost has been reduced by about 0.5%. So just those all index will help assist Egypt to get a better rank in the next ranking in 2015.
Hopefully.
The creation of jobs and the diminishing of unemployment is a very important byproduct of the Suez Canal mega projects, plus, of course, the development of the cities around the canal area. Egypt is expected to be and is hoped to be a very large logistical center, a very big logistical project is expected to be underway with the development of the cities around the canal. What would this mean for Egypt? A lot of people wouldn't understand the logisticals of the development.
Logistical of development, this is the hub of the international trade. Return back to this, what has been also declared in the conference, that the revenue of this canal has reached one of maximum value in the in its history. It has reached about 5 million Egyptian 5 million US dollar in that month, in which with 90 million ton, we just collect $6 per each ton passing through this canal. If we will make the sorting of the containers inside our land, this amount of money could be doubled or tripled within this amount. The logistics, it is not only the Ismailia Canal, but we have the southern port in Suez, in which there is three ports, and also the northern gate in Bursaid, which have, we have also three ports. We want to make a development to improve the logistics in the trade of container between Asia and Europe. So this is the main target of the project. And we hope that because we have a very big opportunity, because all the eastern part of the Suez Canal are completely desert. So we want to improve the land use of this area in making industrial zone and making cultivation.
What about the new cities that would be built and would benefit from the new mega project of the Suez Canal? The new Ismailia, Suez, what about these cities and how they will be profiting from the industrial zones and the Suez Canal project as a whole?
There is a master plan which it will be by a very well-known international consultant firm, which has a branch in Egypt, Dar El Handasa. It will. It has just 6 months to finalize its master plan. According to the master plan, there is, as I mentioned, new Ismailia city, and also the southern gate, because Suez city is located in the western part of. In Port Tawfiq is located in the eastern part. So there is. They will include in their master plan how this south port and also the north port will be improved, or the new project. Which all this project will be collected in one package and presented in the Economic Forum in Sharm el Sheikh, which will be by the end of February or March, next year. So a big challenge for Egypt is how our ability to attract investors in that project. I think that President Sisi also has visited Italy and France and has another plan to visit some countries by the end of this month. If we collect all this, we could just see what could be the impact of this project on the Egyptian economic situation. So I believe I'm very optimistic, as you mentioned, and we hope that it will have a very successful impact on our economy in the next feasible 2 years.
Indeed. Doctor, now, as you said, the big economic conference is to be held in March of next year. A lot of delegations from different countries are expected to attend. When they come, and see the developments that have, I'm sure there will be lots of visits to the Suez Canal, and there's already a lot of visits now for different chambers of commerce and lots of different schools and lots of different organizations, embassies, etc., are getting an opportunity to visit the Suez Canal. And it's a very historic moment because as you stand there and watch, for example, the digging or the dredging, you become aware that in a few years you will not be able to stand here because there will be water, for example. It's really quite a big moment in a person's history and in a person's thought. So what is expected, in your opinion, in March to be said or to be seen at the Suez Canal?
Not all, the conference economic forum will not be only for Suez Canal.
Indeed, yes.
For of course, for different countries, it is the main focus.
Any investor just want to see a pre-feasibility study for a project. And any investor has quite a good, he could evaluate this proposal. For example, if we see we want to make a project A, the impact will be like that, the revenue and the benefit over cost ratio. So this should be done by professionals in all the economic field because we will present several ideas. So the investors, once they will come, I am sure that we have a qualified person in our current government who are very capable of making those pre-feasibility study of a huge amount of project. But let us talk about the, some impact of the Suez Canal. Yes, as you mentioned, it will make a huge impact because we expect, as declared, that the number of ships will be doubled within the 3 years. So this will need quite a few clarification, our impact of the economy on the, of the new Suez Canal on the international trade market, because the international trade is just increased by 2-3%. So we have expectations that the international market will be doubled within the next few years, because the current revenue will be also doubled within the next few years. So our Egyptian vision or point of view should be very clear in that point for the new project. And also to make, we have a lot of legal issue. We should issue a lot of laws concerning encouraging foreign investors to come to Egypt. So I hope, I am sure that we have just quite a short time, three months until the next forum. And as an Egyptian, I wish and I hope that this will be a successful forum. Thank you.
Finally, sir, just a few days to come, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is expected to visit China. And now a delegation is in China, actually, to prepare for the visit by President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. How do you see this visit ahead of the economic forum, which will take place in March?
China is considered one of the top three economy in the world currently. So China has just want to invest in all Africa and has been noticed it is the first investor in Africa for several reasons, because the resources in Africa, I'm talking in Africa in general, and because this is could be a very huge market for China in the near future. And for a political situation, because Africa has about 50 place in any international election. So according to that, we to get a very good diplomatic relationship with China could impact the Egyptian economy, because in that case we could encourage a lot of Chinese company to come and invest in Egypt around Suez Canal or Western. So I think that the economic issues will be discussed clearly between Egyptian and Chinese delegates during this meeting.
Hopefully.
I'm afraid we run out of time. Dr. Haysam Mamdouh, head of the Hydraulics and Irrigation Engineering Department at Alexandria University. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us this morning on the Breakfast Show. Thank you very much.
Yes, and now we'll go to watch this report.